Hello and welcome to Evaluating the Role of the Influencer Model of Social Media Advertising in College Students' Consumer Choices. My name is Tyson Ritter, and I'm joined by my colleague Camille Delaney to present to you our research project. The purpose of this report is to explore the relationship advertisers build with their potential customers through new media advertising, specifically within the framework of the current most popular social media service, TikTok. Primary research was done in the form of a survey targeted at students of Cal Poly Humboldt designed to delineate what makes TikTok so appealing to advertisers when compared with more traditional advertising, i.e. print and video. Further research was conducted in the form of content analysis of several TikTok advertising campaigns and their traditional media counterparts. With social media increasingly becoming the dominant way we interact, especially among younger generations, and with trust in traditional advertising on the decline, it's no surprise that advertisers want to be present in this space. Our team wanted to understand how companies, many of which have been around since long before social media, were able to adapt their advertising model to best draw attention from social media users. We also sought to discover the differing degrees to which audiences were receptive to traditional and new means of advertising. To understand the influencer model in regards to social media advertising, it's important to understand the role that authenticity plays. As we will detail in the following sections, authenticity is the most valuable commodity an influencer has. An influencer is seen as someone who is genuine and demonstrates a thorough understanding of the products and lifestyle they espouse on their channel. They are celebrities, experts, and fellow consumers all rolled into one. If at any point an influencer is seen as betraying the trust and authenticity that has garnered them the support they've enjoyed, they could run the risk of losing their status as an influencer. Therefore, which brands are supported by an influencer is a carefully considered decision. Brands that are represented by influencers generally enjoy a higher level of engagement from an influencer's followers than the population at large, and often, as we'll demonstrate, the influencer's sphere of influence on social media is many times greater than that of multi-million dollar corporations. For our project, we chose four ad campaigns run by the companies Guess, ELF or ELF, Crocs, and Marc Jacobs. These brands were chosen for the success in the social media realm, but also for the reach that their particular ad campaigns had. These are also all fashion brands, because fashion trends represent some of the most widely viewed trends on social media, but also some of the most influencer-driven. Crocs campaign, #$1,000Crocs, saw the company gain over 100,000 followers. Rather than rework the quirky shoe into something more fashionable, they leaned into the unorthodox appearance of the shoe by asking what would a $1,000 pair of Crocs look like. They also joined with recording artists and influencer Moses Malone, as well as YouTuber Adam W., who is known for producing comedic videos. The pair created a music video used to launch the campaign, a campaign which has garnered over 3 billion views across hundreds of short-form videos. For comparison, a 30-second Super Bowl ad gets about 106 million views. Cosmetic brand ELF, or ELF, also deployed a self-named music video, Eyes, Lips, Face, for their campaign. For their effort, they enlisted Hala 561 and Grammy Award-winning songwriter Lil Wayno. Elf also awarded the top TikTok creators with makeup lessons with some of their influencer collaborators. The campaign brought in over 3 billion views.
Do that thing with your eyes. Money, look. Let me see them lips. Attitude and give me bass.
Boom, boom, boom.
Eyes, lips, face, weight.
5, 6, 8.
Guess's campaign, hashtag love Guess, was a more traditional campaign, which didn't feature music videos or teams of influencers, but did manage to rake in 32 million views. Marc Jacobs launched the campaign Perfect As I Am to promote their new perfume by the same name. For this, the company teamed up with influencer Ricky Thompson. For this campaign, TikTok users were asked to record what TikTok calls a duet, in which a pre-recorded video of Ricky Thompson is used and is featured in every user-generated video. Thompson has about 3 million followers, significantly more than Marc Jacobs' 17,000 followers. The video Marc Jacobs used to launch the Perfect As I Am campaign, which features models that were not conventionally attractive, only saw 129 likes. However, the campaign as a whole awarded the fashion brand with over 10 billion views.
Ooh, ow! You are so perfect! Oh, I'm perfect. Okay. Okay, I see you. That's what I'm talking about. Show me your perfect.
What are aspects of myself that I celebrate? All the things that make you weird are what you should celebrate and make even bigger.
Perfect intense.
Our survey was targeted at the general student population of Cal Poly Humboldt, including the students that didn't use social media. The goal was to measure the use of social media, the preference for one social media platform over another, and to collect open-ended responses to questions regarding the ads that they were shown. Because of time constraints, too few responses were gathered to draw any solid statistical conclusions. The amount of respondents was not high enough for multiple choice and Likert response results to be significant. However, the responses to the survey's open-ended questions gave some insight into the motivations and thought process behind college students' engagement with social media and traditional and influencer model advertising. For one survey question, respondents were shown a TikTok influencer model advertisement from the influencer James Charles participating in an ELF ad campaign. One respondent noted that this model of advertisement followed a trend of, quote, making a transformation of some kind slash steps to become more attractive, unquote. Also writing that, quote, James Charles is a well-known influencer with many, many followers, so these videos get many views, unquote. This demonstrates that the respondent is familiar with this model of advertising, by which an influencer who has built a follower base is paid by a company to endorse and model the product to the base. One aspect of the influencer model of advertising that we wanted to investigate was its subtlety. Many influencer-created ads or sponsored content don't appear at face value to be advertisements. To evaluate whether college student respondents considered themselves able to be tricked by influencer ads, we asked, Have you ever engaged with sponsored social media content without immediately knowing it was promotional? To this, 75% of respondents answered yes. This was borne out in a later question, where respondents were shown an influencer ad for ELF's campaign and asked, "What did you think was effective about this influencer ad?" One respondent wrote, quote, "What is it an ad for?" unquote, demonstrating that they didn't know it was an advertisement and underscoring the finding that the influencer model ads often operate with viewers unaware that they are being advertised to.
In conducting the content analysis for our research, we broke down the top 10 TikToks for each brand's campaign using a coded system. We look for the following commonalities: gender featured, whether the TikTok was filmed in a home location, whether the product was featured in the video, the production value of the video, the length of the video, whether professional models or actors were used, and how often humor was deployed. We found that 80% of all TikToks featured women. According to TikTok's own demographics information, 57% of all TikTok users are female. So it's likely the fashion industry, which has historically been geared more towards women, is not diverging from its normal trends in this regard. On the flip side, only 25% of videos featured males, and a smaller percentage, 15%, featured only males with no females. 77.5% featured the products the various brands represented. A similar number, 72.5%, were produced in a home setting. Not surprisingly, all videos appeared to be low production value. Similarly, 100% of posts were short video format, which is partly due to the platform of TikTok. Perhaps one of the most crucial components of successful TikTok posts was the use of humor, coming in at 72.5%.
The power of social media influencers cannot be denied. They hold the level of sway that advertisers and multinational corporations can only dream of, or higher. Their outsized presence in these online spaces dwarfs that of companies with vastly more money and resources. As a result, these influencers are powerful tools for companies looking to increase their own social standing and sell product. Look at any one of their accounts and compare it to an even modest influencer, and you'll no doubt see a vast disparity in regards to followers and engagement. So how do influencers succeed where corporations fail? Again, it comes down to authenticity. Through our research, we have seen firsthand the relationship that is carefully cultivated by influencers with their followers. Their posts are no more complex than what any one of us could create with extra 10 minutes and a smartphone. The use of humor is a huge factor when it comes to appearing authentic, mostly because the humor rarely appears staged and was more spur of the moment. Things like silly faces, bold gestures, simple but effective video editing techniques, and laughter. Many, if not all, people in these videos genuinely appeared to be enjoying themselves in a credible way. We've undoubtedly heard at some point in our lives that the best advertising is word of mouth, and this is essentially that, amplified. Reporter John Herman wrote in a New York Times article from 2021, quote, "One source of TikTok's power, however, is how unprofessional it still feels. Even when people are trying to sell you something, their messages seem off the cuff, like trustworthy recommendations rather than sponsored shilling," unquote.